For these middle school students from Northern California, coming to Hawaii was a dream come true.
About 3 years ago, we planned to come to Hawaii, so we've spent the last 3 years mentally preparing to come here.
They collected money on their own, flew from Vallejo, California, and on their second day here, the news came.
A parent called me at 4 a.m. Hawaii time, roused me out of my sleep and said, you know, ATA went bankrupt, they canceled all your flights. And since that point in time, we have been scrambling, trying to find a way home.
It's been, like, frustrating because we've been, like, you know, we raised enough money to get our plane ticket.
Monica's parents both went home after they heard about ATA's untimely departure.
Kind of sad, like depressed, because I wanted them to watch me, like, motivate.
Parents weren't the only ones leaving.
We had a set number of chaperones, and several bailed out once they heard what was going on.
What started as a group of 25 is now 17. Nine of them competing at the USGWA wrestling tournament held at Wanalua High School.
We kind of use it as motivation to, like, help us wrestle harder. We want to take it out on these girls.
Once Hawaiian Airlines announced they would be adding flights to San Francisco on Monday, a few parents and a coach spent the entire day today at the airport hoping to book a seat on the flights.
It took parents and coaches to basically charge it on their credit card and take a leap of faith that somehow we're going to be recouped those losses.
At a cost of $329 a person times 17 people, the loss comes out to more than $5,000.
It feels good, like there's, like, nothing to worry about anymore.
Olena Rubin, KHON 2 News.